Good evening and welcome to MTV's News Update March 10, 2020 edition. I'm Sandy Ramutar. First, the top stories we're tracking this evening. Chief Justice to rule tomorrow on Region 4 verification challenge. Ghana's election stalemate continues to draw the attention of the international community. Jagdeo berates APNU-AFC for refusal to release statements of poll. And in sport, Russell leads Windies the CLT20 series over Sri Lanka. We tell you now that Chief Justice Roxon George Wiltshire will on Wednesday determine whether the returning officer of Region 4 breached the electoral law when he declared unverified results for that district. Trinidadian Senior Counsel Douglas Mendez, on behalf of the People's Progressive Party Civic, told the court that the returning officer for Region 4, Clement Mingo, did not comply with the process set out in Section 84 of the Representation of the People Act. Mendez said the discontinuation of the verification of the statements of poll after having completed less than 50% of verification does not amount to substantial compliance by the returning officer. The returning officer verified 421 out of 879 statements of poll for District 4. The senior counsel contended that the process to verify the statements of poll for District 4 was not completed and should be verified in the presence of the representatives of the political parties and observers to authenticate the process.
If there is a ruckus, there is an intervention, if there is a boiling down in the place, that will enable the RO to call off the exercise. He doesn't say so. He doesn't say so. And what caused the ruckus? Let us assume that they were ruckus. What caused the intervention? The intervention was caused when the spreadsheet was being used, which spreadsheet did not reflect what was on the statements of poll. That was when there were attempts at interference, when Mr. Lowenfield didn't want to complete the exercise. Everyone knows that. Everyone was there. Everyone saw that. It was not that anyone engineered these things so as to bring the proceedings to an abrupt end or to break up the proceedings. They were done to object, to get compliance and complicity as laid down by the law.
Senior Counsel Neil Boston, representing returning officer for Region 4, Clement Mingo, said the verification process was ongoing and discontinued only after there were discrepancies in the electoral process. For this reason, Boston said the returning officer forged ahead with the declaration as he was permitted to function freely. The senior counsel contended that challenges on irregularities during the election process must wait until the declaration of the final results to mount a challenge by way of an elections petition.
More coming up after the break. Stay with us.
Mark?
I'm in the kitchen.
This is amazing! I love your tiles.
Make an impression with the finest tiles imported by Lens. Lens has a huge selection of various tiles for your wall, floor, and pool needs. All of our tiles are of grade A quality, which are the highest quality tile rated. That means they last longer and are less likely to damage or crack. We're the sole distributor for many reputable companies around the world. At Lens, we have special deals for contractors and bulk shoppers. Shop at any of our locations to get the best in tiles. Lens, our product, your creation.
You can be a millionaire by only spending $100 on a Daily Million ticket. Simply pick any five numbers from 1 to 26, or you can buy a quick pick for your chance to win the Daily Millions. Purchase your tickets daily, Monday through Saturday, to get a chance to win $1 million every day. So, feeling lucky? Then buy a Daily Millions ticket today. Remember, a ticket today could make you rich today.
. 80% of the population around the world have stomachal problems because the water is contaminated. Some of these stomachal problems are diarrhea, cholera, typhoid, filaria. Avoid this sickness with the latest water purifier. Drink clean, fresh mineral water at all the time. Just put water from the pipe, the river, or rainwater at the top of the water purifier, and the system is going to remove all the impurities. Easy to use, easy to sample, no current, no batteries. Purify more than 10,000 liters of water.
Planning a cleanup? We can help. Sevon's waste management skip bins can be provided for home renovation projects, yard cleanups, or construction sites. It's simple. Step one, just pick up the phone and give us a call. Step two, we deliver the skip bin size of your choice. Step three, load the skip with all of your junk. And finally, step four, we take it all away. It's that simple. Bins are also available in various sizes, so there's no job that's too big or too small. Call Sevon's Waste Management today at 218-1455 or 218-1156.
Welcome back. You're watching MTV's News Update. Ghana's stall election continues to draw the attention of the international community. United States Secretary of State Mike Pompeo has announced he has been in talks with Canada about supporting the democratic transition in Ghana.
United States Secretary of State Mike Pompeo on Monday tweeted that he spoke with Deputy Prime Minister of Canada, Chrystia Freeland, supporting the democratic transition in Guyana. International observers from the European Union, the Commonwealth, the Organization of American States, Carter Center, along with Western missions, the United States, Canada, and United Kingdom, have all questioned the integrity of the electoral process. All have issued public statements calling for the tabulation of the results to Region 4 to be conducted in accordance with the law. The returning officer of that region, Clement Mingo, last Thursday declared unverified results, despite calls from many to adhere to the Representation of the People's Act. The statements of poll for nine regions were verified and declared. Only Region 4, the largest voting region, remains unverified. The matter has now made its way before the High Court.
The People's Progressive Party Civic is questioning why the Partnership for National Unity Alliance for Change is reluctant to release its statements of poll as the party claims it has won the elections.
General Secretary of the PPP Bharat Jagdeo has raised suspicion about the coalition's reluctance to have the Region 4 results verified in keeping with the law. The Partnership for National Unity Alliance for Change claimed it has won the 2020 elections but has not yet released any statement of poll. The People's Progressive Party Civic last Thursday released its statements of poll in an act of transparency, providing why there is need for the verification of the results of Region 4, as the declared figure does not match theirs. The PPC is adamant that the results should be verified using the statements of poll.
We know they would not do that, because if they do it, then it will show that APNU has lost the elections and that in fictitious numbers that were declared by the RO, that came from where we don't know, because all of the statements of poll that were being used for the verification by the RO was lying in an office in front of all of the observers and the representatives of the party when he made that declaration outside of that office.
Jagdeo said the party has briefed all the international partners about the stalled elections. He assured that steps are being taken to ensure the elections are not stolen. Jagdeo warned that should Mr. Granger be sworn in unconstitutionally, the party will pursue and call for international sanctions.
And the international community has made it clear that there shall be sanctions if that happens for them and their families. Travel restrictions, a whole range of other types of sanctions. There will be sanctions to the country for doing business with this government, etc. So many of them think that, oh, they can survive this. That is not the leadership there, because they would have some oil money. Even that would be undergo sanctions.
The heads of mission of the Embassy of the United States of America, the British High Commission, the Canadian High Commission, and the European Union all called on President Granger to avoid a transition of government. The four foreign missions said it would be unconstitutional, as it would be based on a vote tabulation process that lacked credibility and transparency.
Opposition leader Bharat Jagdeo is refuting claims accusing the People's Progressive Party of hiring Russian agents to hack into the electoral system during the March to general and regional elections.
Jagdeo categorically stated that Guyana's electoral system is one which allows for each vote to be tallied manually.
There are other rumors like, oh, the PPP brought Russians in before the elections to hack this system. You can't hack people's fingers. We have a manual system. How do you hack a person's finger in the polling place and tell him how to vote? So after that happened, the count was done right there. It's a manual count. And the statements of poll were signed by all the parties, reflected that count, and posted outside of the polling places.
Jagdeo is accusing the coalition for instigating falsified information, which argues the opposition provided Russian agents to possibly help rig Guyana's elections.
And they're watching Freedom House and many other places. There is a unit that is working with the Ministry of the Presidency and with Felix and Paul Slow, who are connected with elements in the police force. They have handpicked the people they're using, so they're removing decent police officers from various places. So the latest example was their claim that they caught up Mark Phillips with a Russian guy at the Marriott. Now that guy who was at the Marriott, he is a former executive director, US executive director to the Inter-American Development Bank, appointed by President Obama. When they arrested the guy called us, and I sent Mark Phillips to go over there to see that what they were doing. They just wanted to expel the foreigners from the country.
It was recently published that the opposition hired the U.S. lobby group Mercury Public Affairs to help run its elections campaign. The said firm is presently embroiled in a probe regarding alleged Russian interference in the U.S. The contract was said to have been signed on March 5, 2019 by PPPC Executive Secretary Zulfikar Mustafa. Reporting from TV News Update, Lashona Gomes, Cornelius.
Still ahead, mission pensioner found in GP8C with physical injuries, and car plunges off the Demerara Harbour Bridge into the Demerara River.
Let FiberTech help you to renovate, refresh, and redecorate your kitchen. Spice up your kitchen with decorative colors, finishes, and accessories. Choose from an array of designs and beautiful granite colors that are blended to suit your choice. FiberTech Lifetime Kitchen is durable, termites-free, and water-resistant. Enjoy 1-year factory warranty, along with our after-sales service. So come on in and let us help you choose wisely.
Using Softex toilet tissue. Available in leading supermarkets countrywide, Softex is always silky smooth because it's made from virgin pulp and babies love it. Softex comes available in single rolls, economy pack, six pack, and one dozen packages. Just perfect for any budget. Manufactured and distributed by BPATS Paper Manufacturing, Eccles Industrial Site. For more information, telephone 622-4197.
Hey, you have a growing flesh there, and there too, and there is another one. Those ugly and annoying growing flesh, like a plague, ignoring them, and before you know, you have them everywhere. SlimJet, presenting Coliomac, the most effective growing flesh and wart remover. Painlessly remove ugly growing flesh is the quick and effective way. Get soft, smooth, growing flesh-free skin, guarantee. Just apply Coliomac twice a day and the growing flesh just dry up and fall off. Easy, quick, and painless. Stop suffering and feeling embarrassed. Remove those ugly growing flesh with Coliomac. Only at the SlimJet, City Mall, second floor.
Start feeling good again with Probiotic XL. Probiotic XL contains a proprietary formula of 10 of the most important probiotics that have been researched and developed to help your body get rid of what's bad for it and help promote what makes you feel good. If leading a healthy life and enjoying every day is something you want to do, then Probiotic XL is for you.
Welcome back. You're still at MTV's News Update. An 83-year-old Masjid caretaker who was missing for 6 days was found in a Georgian public hospital with bruises about his body. His relatives are suspecting he was physically assaulted.
83-year-old Nadir Hussein, the caretaker of the Masjid at Pleasance, was reported missing on Wednesday by his relatives after he did not return home. This morning, they received a phone call from a person who wished to remain anonymous, who said the elderly man was a patient in the male surgical ward at the Georgetown Public Hospital Corporation. According to the man's nephew, when he paid a visit to his uncle, there were signs of assault.
Well, I didn't go to see him at the hospital. My brother went with his daughter, and they're saying they're seeing like burn marks on his skin, like by his upper thigh. They're seeing burn marks on that part of his skin, and there were a few bruises, cuts and bruises, etc., on his skin. So, but when asked questions, he hasn't been willing to give any further information as to what really transpired.
However, the man can neither remember how he received the injuries nor how he reached the hospital. According to his relatives, he was physically assaulted and left on the road. He was picked up by passing emergency medical technicians and carried to the hospital, where he was admitted.
Well, he's supposed to be released from the hospital today, as to what the nurses said. So maybe when he's at home and he's in a much more comfortable environment, we might be able to get a little bit more information on what really transpired. But like I said earlier, whilst talking to him whilst he was there, he's not willing to give any further information as to what really happened.
Luan Williams reporting for MTV News Update.
A 45-year-old man is counting his lucky stars after his car suffered a blowout on the Demor Harbour Bridge. His car crashed into the retractor span and then made a plunge into the Demor Harbour River.
The incident occurred around 23 hours 30. The vehicle bearing license plate number PNN8879 was driven by 45-year-old Bill Calder of Turkine, Greater Georgetown. According to a police source, the front right side wheel suffered a blowout, which caused the driver to lose control of the vehicle and eventually causing the vehicle to plunge into the river. The man had to smash his windshield to escape death.
Taking to get medical attention because he received some injuries.
Okay.
I think some damage was done to a pontoon or cabin or something belonging to the bridge, so that will be sorted out later on. Mm-hmm. If he went into the river, I should say, we will treat it as an incident. But the bridge and enough to work out.
The driver sustained injuries and is receiving medical attention at the hospital. The police were not able to conduct a breathalyzer test on him. According to reports, the retractor span on the Demerara Harbor Bridge is damaged and no vessels would be able to pass until the span is fixed. This newscast contacted the general manager of the Demerara Harbor Bridge, Ralston Adams, who assured that works are being done to fix the damages. Luan Williams reporting for MTV's News Update.
Activists Moses Bagwan and Onsek Wayana have issued a call on the two major political leaders and parties to put the interests of Ghana on the table and have an immediate agreement of a joint government based on the verified results of the 2020 elections. The political activists called for the formation of a government of national unity out of the chaos that followed the March 2020 regional and general election. The duo said regardless of the court's decision, it is important for the country's leaders to find a mutually agreeable solution with Ghana first in mind. Coming up after the break, regional and international news, court roundup and more. Stay with us.
Modern Optical Service has made it even better by introducing its budgeted spectacle line, starting as low as $10,000 for a single vision lens and $12,000 for a bifocal lens, available in tinted or clear, complete spectacles at affordable prices. So hurry down to our main office at 316 Middle Street or Lot 14 Diamond Public Road opposite Demerara Bank. Enjoy over 60 years of eye care experience at affordable prices. Modern Optical Service, your eye care professionals.
Everything is connected, our planet, our water sources, including the water we drink. Sometimes harmful bacteria end up in our streams and canals. Although treated, the risks are high. You can prevent this pollution and contamination by maintaining your septic tank and grease traps. Call the experts at Puran Brothers Disposal Incorporated on 264-1239 or 603-5050. Keeping it clean is what we do best.
Beeson Windows and Doors, fully equipped to handle all your commercial projects. Whether you're constructing a small or large commercial building, residential property, or just upgrading your home, they got you covered. Beeson Windows and Doors, providing unmatched quality windows for your home, office, and commercial building. Located at 1228 Eccles Industrial Site. For more information, call 662-4197 or 226-1292.
Welcome back. Now for some news from in the region. Police in Chile are searching for members of an armed gang who stole a cash shipment worth about 11.5 million pounds from a warehouse at Santiago Airport. At least seven men entered the cargo area of the airport where the cash was stored and forced the security guards to hand the money over at gunpoint. They used two vehicles, one painted in the colors and one with the logo of courier company DHL. Police say they suspect the gang had inside information. The cash shipment of dollars and euros had arrived from abroad shortly before robbery and was due to be taken to banks in Chile. An airport security guard was injured after receiving a blow to the head. One of the vans used in the robbery was later found abandoned and partially burnt. Police said it did not belong to the courier company DHL, but had been painted to look like it. It is not the first time a multi-million dollar sum has been stolen from the Arturo Merino Bendres Airport. In 2014, a gang of nine men stole a cash shipment worth $10 million. Following that robbery, the airport security chief at the time was sacked. Internationally, everyone arriving in Israel will be required to self-quarantine for 14 days to prevent the spread of coronavirus, Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu says. All those coming to Israel from abroad will be placed in isolation, he said in a video address posted on Twitter. Israeli Interior Minister Ariel Harari said the measure would be effective immediately for all the residents returning to the country. It will apply to foreign citizens from Thursday, he added. The move means that foreign arrivals will have to prove that they have adequate accommodation to be quarantined during their stay in the country. After a day of complex discussions, we made a decision. Everyone who comes to Israel from abroad will enter 14-day isolation, Mr. Nathwanu said in a statement. This is a tough decision, but it is essential to maintain public health, and public health precedes everything. He added that the ruling would be valid for 2 weeks. The measure means that about 268,000 Israelis who are currently abroad would need to quarantine themselves on their return, Israel media report. Israel, a country with a population of about 9 million, has so far recorded 42 cases of COVID-19, but no deaths. The country has already imposed restrictions on travelers arriving from several countries, including Italy, the worst-hit European country. Now for your quote roundup.
A man was today sentenced after he confessed to the 2018 killing of his son as he appeared before Justice Sandil Kisun at the Demerara High Court. 46-year-old Mohan Sukdio of Fowles, East Coast Demerara, was charged for the capital offense of murder, but opted to plead guilty to the lesser count of manslaughter and admitted that on September 8, 2018 at Law 217 Fowles, East Coast Demerara, he murdered 21-year-old Satish Kevin Sukdio. Satish was fatally stabbed by his father when he tried to save his mother, who was being choked and assaulted. Justice Kisun explained that the case was disturbing and stated that Satish rescued his mother and lost his life by doing so. The judge considered the savage and brutal act of domestic violence in which a son was killed by the hands of his own father and sentenced Sukdio to 20 years imprisonment. He also ordered that the time Sukdio spent on remand be deducted from the sentence. In another matter, a fisherman was today sentenced to 18 years imprisonment by Justice Sandil Kisun for killing his workmate. 45-year-old Sharif Bakas was charged for the capital offense of murder, but opted to plead guilty to the lesser count of manslaughter and admitted that on July 20, 2017 at Meadowbank Wharf, Georgetown, he unlawfully killed 42-year-old Chan Wing Wong. According to reports, Bakas and Wong were both fishermen who worked at the Meadowbank Wharf. On the day in question, the men had an altercation which escalated into a physical confrontation. The duo was parted by onlookers and Wong walked away, but only to be pursued by backers who, once he caught up with Wong, stabbed him to the left region of his chest, after which he fled the scene. Wong collapsed and was taken to the Joshong Public Hospital, where he was pronounced dead on arrival. The judge, after considering Backus' plea and the nature of the case, sentenced him to 18 years imprisonment. Meanwhile, a father of three today appeared before Chief Magistrate Anne McLennan in the Joshong Magistrate's Courts to answer for stealing a woman's cell phone. Philbert Cush, 53, of Lot 41 Broad Street, Charlestown, pleaded guilty to the charge which read that on February 26 at Lot 48 Robb Street, Georgetown, he stole a cell phone valued $260,000, property of Rhonda Harry. Reports indicate that on the day in question, the virtual complainant was at her clothing store doing some cleaning and had her cell phone on a table when the accused walked in and started pricing items. Reports further indicate that the man then picked up the woman's phone unbeknownst to her and left the store. However, video footage obtained from a nearby building showed the man stealing the phone, and he was subsequently arrested and taken to the Breakdown Police Station, where he was placed on ID parade and was positively identified by the victim. He was told of the offense, to which he allegedly admitted and was charged. When given a chance to explain why he committed the act, the defendant told the magistrate that he was under the influence of alcohol and needed money. He apologized for committing the crime and pleaded with the magistrate for forgiveness and a second chance. After listening to both sides, the magistrate stated that she considered the fact that Cush did not waste the court's time, as well as his apology to the court. However, she stated that she also took into consideration the value of the article as well as the prevalence of the offense and sentenced Philbert Cush to 18 months imprisonment. Finally, a taxi driver was today hauled before the court to answer to an armed robbery charge. 31-year-old Nicholas Chung of Lot 254 Freeman Street East Le Penitence denied a charge against him, which alleged that on February 28, while in the company of others and armed with a gun, he robbed Neil Dutchin of $500,000 cash, a cell phone valued $20,000, and a knife valued $500, reaching the total value of $520,500. According to reports on the day in question, the virtual complainant and friends were at the Blue Martini nightclub, where the accused and the victim had a misunderstanding. The defendant reportedly left but returned with two accomplices, one who was armed with a gun, which he used to shoot the victim once to the abdomen and once to the right leg. However, the incident was captured on CCTV cameras and an investigation was carried out which led to the arrest of the defendant. The prosecution objected to bail, citing the fact that the virtual complainant remains hospitalized, as well as the prevalence of the offense. As such, bail was refused and Nicholas Chung was remanded to prison until March 25. Reporting for MTV's Court Roundup, Cillian Griffith. Hiccups are involuntary contractions of the diaphragm, the muscle that separates your chest from your abdomen and plays an important role in breathing. Each contraction is followed by a sudden closure of your vocal cords, which produces the characteristic hic sound. Hiccups may result from a large meal, alcoholic or carbonated beverages, or sudden excitement. In some cases, hiccups may be a sign of an underlying medical condition. For most people, a bout of hiccups usually lasts only a few minutes. Rarely, hiccups may persist for months. This can result in weight loss and exhaustion. Symptoms. Hiccuping is a symptom. It may sometimes be accompanied by a slight tightening sensation in your chest, abdomen, or throat. Causes. The most common triggers for hiccups that last less than 48 hours include drinking carbonated beverages, drinking too much alcohol, eating too much, excitement or emotional stress, sudden temperature changes, swallowing air with chewing gum or sucking on candy. Hiccups that last more than 48 hours may be caused by 1. Nerve damage or irritation. A cause of long-term hiccups is damage to or irritation of the vagus nerves or phrenic nerves, which serve the diaphragm muscle. Factors that may cause damage or irritation to these nerves include a hair or something else in your ear touching your eardrum, a tumor, cyst, or goiter in your neck, gastroesophageal reflux, sore throat or laryngitis, central nervous system disorders. 2. A tumor or infection in your central nervous system or damage to your central nervous system as a result of trauma can disrupt your body's normal control of the hiccup reflex. Examples include meningitis, stroke, traumatic brain injury, tumors, metabolic disorders, and drugs. Long-term hiccups can be triggered by alcoholism, anesthesia, diabetes, electrolyte imbalance, kidney disease, steroids, tranquilizers. Risk factors. Men are much more likely to develop long-term hiccups than are women. Other factors that may increase your risk of hiccups include mental or emotional issues. Anxiety, stress, and excitement have been associated with some cases of short-term and long-term hiccups. Surgery. Some people develop hiccups after undergoing general anesthesia or after procedures that involve abdominal organs. Treatment. Most cases of hiccups go away on their own without medical treatment. If an underlying medical condition is causing your hiccups, treatment of that illness may eliminate the hiccups. Lifestyle and home remedies. Although there's no certain way to stop hiccups, if you have a bout of hiccups that lasts longer than a few minutes, the following home remedies may provide relief, although they are unproven. 1. Breathe into a paper bag. 2. Gargle with ice water. 3. Hold your breath. 4. Sip cold water. If you have chronic hiccups, avoiding carbonated beverages and gas-producing foods, as well as eating smaller meals, may help.
And welcome to the Star Technology Wrap. I'm your host Rajesh Lakhan along with Keen, and this week we'll be touching on the Epson EcoTank printer. Keen, tell us about them.
Yes, Rajesh. Hello to you and hello to our viewers. Today we want to talk about the Epson EcoTank printers, which are new arrivals here at Star Computer. The Epson EcoTank printers usually work very well if you're going to be doing high volume printing, if you're looking for a higher resolution, better quality, and of course the inks and the overall maintenance of the printer is very, very cost effective.
Go ahead, elaborate a little on the inks for me.
All right, usually we all are accustomed to the ink cartridges, which you place inside of the printer. However, with the EcoTank, this uses the bottle inks, which you use, which you pour to the side of the printer. So in terms of the bottle inks, they are much more, it's much more bigger than the cartridges.
More printing,
correct.
Keen, anything else you want to say to the viewers?
Yes, I would advise our viewers to come down and come into the store. We'll be able to assist you, give you a demo on the printers, the Epson EcoTank printers, and the wider variety that we have. Also, you can check us our page on Facebook, Star Computers, and you'll be able to see all the... Well, you can like our page, follow us, and, you know, you can get in on the work. Correct.
Great. And just to inform the viewers, you guys don't only carry Epson line of printers, you also carry the H3 brand.
Wide variety of the H3 brand also.
Well, thank you, Keith. And that's what we have for you in this week's edition of Star Technology Wrap. Do join us next week, Monday, for another edition.
Get the right seal right now from Industrial Supply of Guyana, Inc., your immediate SKF sealing solutions. The SKF seal jet machine is capable of building seals from 5mm to 600mm in diameter in under 5 minutes. With technical support readily available, you can get a customized seal to suit virtually any industrial application, like buffer, rod, wiper, and piston seals. SKF seal jet machine, now at Industrial Supply of Guyana, Inc.
Welcome to MTV's Sports Update. Ramdani siblings Narayan and Priyana secured fourth place finishes in the 2020 CCA Badminton National Championships last weekend.
Tackling for the King's University Eagles, Narayan secured fourth place in the men's singles. Meanwhile, playing for the Olds College Broncos, Priyana secured fourth place in the women's singles. The sibling duo won silver medals at the ACAC Provincial Championships in Edmonton and qualified to represent Alberta at the Canadian Collegiate Athletic Association Nationals. Also featured were over 15 college and university players, adding to the competitive atmosphere with high performances. The Guyana Badminton Association is pleased with the local badminton stars' performances, especially for making their way into the nationals' top four. Chelsea Lee, reporting for MTV's Sports Update.
Saturday's match between France and Ireland is the latest Six Nations fixture to be postponed because of concerns over the coronavirus outbreak. The decision follows earlier steps to postpone the Ireland vs Italy and Italy vs England fixtures. England lead the table on points difference from France, who failed in a group grand slam bid with defeat by Scotland on Sunday. As it stands, the Wales match against Scotland will go ahead on March 14. The women's Six Nations fixture between Wales and Scotland has, however, been postponed. The decision to postpone England's match in Italy was taken last week because of the worsening situation in the country, and on Sunday, France announced a ban of gatherings of more than 1,000 people. On Monday, the French sports minister Roxana Marciniano announced the decision to postpone France's final fixture after an agreement with the French Rugby Federation and tournament organizers. England, France and Ireland remain in contention for the Six Nations. The Leeward Islands Hurricanes proved a troublesome opponent for the Ghana Jaguars in the Regional 4A Championship last weekend.
Ending on a draw, the Jaguars set 112 in a minimum of 12 overs, and the Hurricanes' top order batted through before the match ended. The Jags then declared their second innings before the rescheduled close after wicketkeeper batsman Anthony Bramble led the batting with a 69 and skipper Leon Johnson supported with 63. However, Rakim Cornwall sneered Tej Narayan Chanderpaul, Tevin Imlach and Vishal Singh in some destructive spells to send the Jags reeling on 24 for 3. But Johnson anchored a successive half-century stand with Christopher Barnwell and Bramble to stabilize the innings. Earlier, the Jags needed 25 minutes to wrap up the Hurricanes' first innings after the visitors resumed play on 353 for 7. Left-arm spinner Veerasamy Parmal ended with 4 for 102 from 45 overs to carry his tally of scalps for the season to 49, and left-arm pacer Raymond Reefer finished with 3 for 79 from 27 overs. This draw means the Jaguars remain in second position on the overall standing behind Barbados Pride. Chelsea Lee, reporter for MTV's Sports Update.
Former Brazil and Barcelona player Ronaldinho Gaúcho is adapting quickly to life in a Paraguayan jail, but his lawyers are hopeful he may soon be released into house arrest while the investigation continues. Prison warden Bless Vera said, in broad terms, he's doing well and is in good spirits, always smiling. Vera said that Ronaldinho and his brother Roberto Assis, who were arrested on Friday for using a false Paraguayan passport, would present their case to a judge today. Their lawyer Sergio Quiroz told Reuters they had asked a court to release them into house arrest and offered guarantees they were not of flight risk. Vera said the forward and his brother had beds, a television and a fan in their cell at the prison on the outskirts of the capital, Asuncion. The brothers use a communal bathroom and have the right to use the outdoor patio on a regular basis. The pair's lawyers have provided them with meals and they have not eaten the food offered by the jail. Ghana's Jasmine Belengi and Samara Sukai dominated the divisions in the 2020 Silver Bowls Junior Table Tennis Championships.
Copping the under 11 title was Belengi, while Sukai bagged the under 9. Belengi competed in the under 13 category, where she easily ran undefeated to earn her place in the finals. However, she bowed out 3-1 to Chloe Fraser as she lost the game 11-6, but went on to win the second one 11-8 to level the scores. Going into the under 11 finale, Belengi flipped the table to win 3-1 with scores of 11-5, 11-3, and 11-7 to cop the title. Meanwhile, over in the under 9 category, Sukai won 3-0 with scores of 11-1, 11-2, and 11-0. Chelsea Lee, reporting for MTV's Sports Update.
Spain's Ivan Garcia Cortina claimed a shock win in a bunch sprint finish on stage 3 of Paris Nice. The Bahrain McLaren rider kicked early and easily held off three-time world champion Peter Sagan in Le Chatre with Andrea Pascual in third. Germany's Mark Schulman retained his overall lead in the race, which is being held behind closed doors because of the coronavirus outbreak. Stage 4 on Wednesday is a 15.1 km individual time trial in Saint-Amand-Montrent. The race concludes on Sunday. Yesterday, race organizers detailed measures to comply with the French Ministry of Health's ban and gathering of more than 1,000 people in response to the coronavirus outbreak. Public access is restricted at the start and the end of each stage, and there is a buzzer zone of 100 meters to the podium at the start of the stage and 300 meters at the end. 7 teams pulled out of the race because of concerns over coronavirus, while Team UNESA's withdrawal was also in part because of the death of sporting director Nicholas Porter. Andrew Russell catapulted West Indies to a 7-wicket victory over Sri Lanka to sweep the 2-match T20 series.
Russell bagged 40 not out, smashing 6 sixes in 14 balls for a successful chase of 156 for their side. Sherman Hetmyer top-scored, registering 43 not out, while Brandon King smashed a career-best 43 to lay the groundwork. The West Indies had conceded 46 from the final 23 balls, and Sri Lanka was able to reach 155 for 6 from their 20 overs. They bowled tightly up front and restricted the Sri Lankans to 109 for 6 in the 17th over after the home team was put into bat. West Indies were set back early in the chase, but King played freely and propelled them to 61 for 1 at the close of the power play overs. Needing 69 from 60 balls at the halfway stage, Hetmyer brought up 100 for his second boundary. Earlier, O'Shane Thomas made the breakthrough for the West Indies in the third over, but Sri Lanka prevailed to reach 44 for 1 at the close of the power play overs. Windies managed to restrict the hosts to 75 for 3 at the halfway stage as Dwayne Bravo and Sheldon Cottrell put them squarely on top to sweep the series. Chelsea Lee, reporting for MTV's Sports Update.
More news after the break. Stay with us.
Welcome to Industrial Supply of Guyana, Inc., Guyana's sole distributor of NP and Ultra Lubricants, SKF Bearings, Seal and Belts, International Trucks and Parts, and Napa Batteries. With a bond capacity of 30,000 square foot, we offer superior brands at affordable prices and the best after-sales service. ISG supplies sustainable integrated solutions to make your business a growing success. Visit us at our new main office at Lot 4Q, Peters Hall. ISG, the best opportunity to make the right choice.
And that has brought us to the end of MTV's Sports Update. Let's now turn our attention to the Demerara Harbour Bridge and the Burpees River Bridge schedules. This is where we wrap up this evening's broadcast, but before we go, here's a reminder of our top stories. Chief Justice rule tomorrow on Region 4 verification challenge. Ghana's election stalemate continues to draw the attention of the international community. Jagdeo berates AP and UAFC for refusal to release statements of poll. And in sport, Russell leads Windies to seal T20 series over Sri Lanka. Catch our rebroadcast at 23 hours today and at 6 hours 30 tomorrow. On behalf of our news and technical teams, I'm Sandy Ramutar. Have a good night.